forgot I think I had my video camera. We can walk up there.
With the fangs on the elbows serve sort of the same practicality of the hands?
Well, this is something that's a bit mysterious to us, and when we go over and look at the Coyoshalki stone, you'll notice that she has these fanged faces on her elbows and on her knees as well. We don't quite know what that implies, but this does appear in other art traditions in other parts of the world, including Asia as well as Europe.
Yeah.
And it seems to have something to do with shamanic ideology. There are traditions up in Siberia of powerful shamans having the ability to create magic with other parts of the body. And they attribute faces and things to that, and there are sketches of like witches that were done in German block prints that show witches with like faces on their elbows and on their knees. Yeah. We don't actually have a specific a colonial interpretation for what this is, but by cross-cultural comparison to other traditions involving these kinds of creatures, this is not an it's almost as if those parts of the body are also considered to have powerful spiritual forces. Holistic medicine people, especially if they're trained with Asian medicine and Chinese medicine, often talk about various parts of the body as having particular types of personality or almost characteristics. Some things are just so horribly broken up.